become the new creation. With the very best of us joins with your perfection to create something supernaturally beautiful. We recognize, Lord, that sometimes we need to go through the fire. We need to go through the flood water. We need to go through those testing times. We need to go through those hard times to be refined, to be shaped, to be molded, to be changed. Before you start, Christopher, I just want to thank everybody for their prayers.
Yes.
I'm almost 100%. I'm about 95%. I just need strength to get back. But as far as like breathing and everything else, I'm good. So thank you for your prayers. I'm glad to be back. I missed your something of fears. So.
I am chosen to be a witness to the one true God.
I am chosen to be a witness to the one true God.
I am called to know him.
I am called to know him.
Believe him.
Believe him.
Trust him.
Trust him.
Serve him.
Serve him.
Faithfully.
Faithfully.
And testify to the fact.
And testify to the fact.
There is no other God.
There is no other God.
There never has been.
There never has been.
Or ever will be.
There never will be.
He is eternal.
He is eternal.
Without him, there is no Savior.
Without him, there is no Savior.
No one can snatch me up.
No one can snatch me up.
Out of his hand.
Out of his hand.
Because no one can stop him.
Because no one can stop him.
Or undo what he has done.
Or undo.
I trust God.
I trust God.
I trust his power.
I trust his power.
To provide for me.
To provide for me.
And save me.
And save me.
I have a deep respect for God.
I have a deep respect for God.
I do not test him.
I do not test him.
By demanding.
By demanding.
He do things my way.
He do things my way.
Or within my time frame.
Or within my time frame.
My life is a testimony to his loving care.
My life is a testimony to his loving care.
There is no problem in my life that he cannot solve.
There is no problem in my life that he cannot solve.
God, let your fire.
Thank you. Turns out that was just the devil talking, and guess what? He lied.
Yeah.
I am not the sort of person I believed for years to be. Jesus died and rose again just to set me free.
Oh.
Now I see how special I am. I get three in one. God the Father, Holy Spirit, and Jesus is his Son. Now that I have them in my life, I don't seem so lonely and sad. Now that I have God as my Lord and Savior, he's the Father I never had. I used to be filled with so much pain, guilt, and shame hidden deep inside. Now I'm surrounded by his love and mercy. I no longer want to hide. So I suggest it's time for us to realize just how precious we are to him. Stop fighting the battle he already died for us to win.
Yeah!
I used to believe in all the lies the devil told me about me. Now I'm no longer a slave to fear. I'm a child of God and I am free.
Yeah, amen.
We have all lived in sin and darkness and believe things that just aren't true. But I'm here to tell you, if you give your life to Jesus, there's nothing that he can't do.
Thank you, Lord.
You know, thank you for that. That was, that's awesome. Awesome, awesome. I'm struggling right now, again, with giving everything up to him. I feel that, you know, I'm this big woman and I can take on the world and I can take on everything myself. And I can't do it no more. And I don't want to give up again. And the suicide thoughts are not there.
Yeah.
So thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
My shoes are still off. But I'm still struggling so hard with this codependent thing. And I can't get rid of it so bad, and I'm hurting so bad. And the Lord told me that I've got to him, and I have to testify through my mouth to somebody. So I'm testifying to all of you, because you are my family.
Amen.
I don't have no family, and all I have is you. I have my Lord Jesus as my Savior, and I know that, but I'm so lost, it's crazy.
You're so found. Yeah.
And I just don't know what to do anymore. I really don't.
Yes.
I'm so scared.
You're fine. You're safe.
We want to save the world, and I'm safe.
And you want to save the world, of course. We just call out that Holy Spirit in her to get that out of the door, because she can't do anything apart from you.
Right.
We know, Lord, that you will empower her to do all the things that you call her to. And we just call out that spirit that wants to try to accuse her falsely, Lord. We just plead your blood. We thank you for her. We thank you for her heart for you, Lord. She loves you, Jesus. She loves you. And with a whole heart, I see it in her when she's worshiping you, Lord God. And so we just agree together as the family of God for her freedom, Lord.
Yes.
For her
yes.
peace.
Yes.
For her joy, for her happiness, Lord, in you alone, Lord, because you are the source of everything that she needs. And we thank you, Lord, for that peace. We thank you, Lord, for your joy, your hope, your healing, Lord, for all the old parts of her that are hurting, Lord. We just agree for her cures. We agree for your love to fill those voids, Lord God, where she tries to reach out in other ways, Lord God. We just agree right now. Thank you, Jesus, for your hope. Thank you, Jesus. We call out your spirit in every question.
Thank you, Lord. You're not asking Tiffany to stop being codependent. You're asking her to shift her codependency.
Right.
Command to you.
Amen.
You are the one who meets that need. God, you are the one who meets that need.
Awesome.
Yes.
It's just a shift.
Let me depend on you.
Right. It's just a shift. It's just a shift. You're designed to be codependent.
Yes.
So here's the word. Immediately when you said that, Jesus reminded me of the words from that song. How can I be lost when you have called me found?
Right.
Yeah.
Right there.
Amen.
Right there.
Amen.
He's called us found.
I didn't look up. I just heard it. Microphone. I'm like, oh, I'm on earth.
Go God. Amen. And that's really what we're going to test.
restoration. He doesn't just rescue, and yes, he redeems, but he restores.
Amen.
He restores.
To all my
I can walk right through. That's a picture of an impossible situation. Where God, what it looked like, God had just rescued Israel out of slavery. We've all tasted that. We know that God, at some point, God has stepped in and set us free. Okay? He has. He's done it. It's already been in play. But we come to this place where they meet the Red Sea, and now Pharaoh is angry and is taking his whole army to chase after them and kill them. And Moses, all he knows to do is stick out a stick. But they're standing at the sea, and there's no way for them to get around it, to go over it. And they sure as heck don't think they can go through it. More than that.
Millions.
It was probably millions.
Crazy.
So Moses takes the staff and stretches it out. I think he probably touched the water. And the Red Sea separates. And all of the Israelites walk across to the other side on dry land. And then Pharaoh and his whole army is swallowed up into the sea as they chase after them. God wants you to know today to proclaim this. You split the sea so I can walk through. That means you take the impossible situation and you make a way where there seems to be no way. You take an impossible thing. I know some of you right now are looking at, you have no idea how you're going to move forward. You have no idea what your next step is. You have no idea. And you're battling fear. You're battling that thing that says, don't turn and run. Don't run. Don't run back to your old coping mechanisms. Don't run back to fear. Don't run back to hopelessness. Don't run back to discouragement. Don't run. He's taking you this far. He's not going to stop now. He's taking you this far. He's not going to stop now. You need to stand at the water's edge and put your stick in the water. You're not a slave to fear, so don't let it rule you. As much as the Israelites were enslaved to the Egyptians, what they were enslaved to was fear. And they took on that slave mentality. You're no longer a slave, you're a son or a daughter. You're a son or a daughter with the rights, the authority, with the power of being a son or daughter of the king. You're no longer a slave to fear. He splits the sea so you can walk right through it. So take hold of those things that look impossible today, and you stand. You armor yourself up, and you stand. Galatians 5:22 is the fruit of the Spirit. Ephesians 6 is the armor. Those two chapters in the Bible are really, really important to know and what the Spirit is doing for you and what the armor does to protect you. All right, let's have an awesome day.
Jesus! Thank you.
One thing, there's a big cat in the hood. And he says that it's finished.
Yeah.
As far as the east is from the west. Yeah. It's finished.
It's finished.
Yes.
Amen.
The line of Judah.